Welcome to our lesson on section 3.6, Applications of Bessel Functions. So Bessel's equation of order p is in the form of z squared times the second derivative of w with respect to z, plus z times the first derivative of w with respect to z, plus z squared minus p squared times w is equal to 0. And substitute w to be x to the negative alpha times y, and z to be x k times x to the beta power. Then the transformation then will yield x squared times y double prime plus 1 minus 2 alpha times x times y prime plus alpha squared minus beta squared times p squared plus beta squared times k squared times x to the 2 times beta power. All that times y is equal to 0. 2, x squared times y double prime plus ax times y prime plus b plus c times x to the q power times y is equal to 0, with constants a being 1 minus 2 alpha, b being alpha squared minus beta squared times p squared, and c being beta squared times k squared, and q being 2 times beta. And we can solve these to make alpha be 1 minus a over 2, beta to be q over 2, k to be 2 times the square root of c divided by q, and p to be the square root of 1 minus a, the whole quantity squared, minus 4 times b, all divided by q. If we assume the square roots are all real, p is not an integer, the general solution then will be y of x is equal to x to the alpha times w of z. So x to the alpha times w of k times x to the beta, where w of z is c sub 1 times j sub p of x of z, excuse me, plus c sub 2 times y sub negative p of z. So theorem 1 for the solutions in Bessel functions: if c is greater than 0, q non-zero, 1 minus a, that whole quantity squared, greater than or equal to 4b, then the general solution for x is greater than 0 is y of x is equal to x to the alpha times c sub 1 times j sub p times of k times x to the beta plus c sub 2 times j sub negative p of k times x to the beta, where alpha, beta, k, p are all given by their equations. If p is an integer, then j sub negative p is to be replaced by y sub p. So I have here an example. We want to solve this equation: 4x squared times y double prime plus 8xy prime plus 4 x to the fourth power minus 3 all times, all that times y is equal to 0. So for us to do this, we are first going to divide by 4. So what does that yield? That gives us x squared times y double prime plus 2 times x times y prime plus, this would be negative 3/4, plus 1/4 times x to the fourth. All that times y is equal to 0. And now we have it in that formation before from 2 slides ago. So we could then obtain our values: a to be 2, b to be negative 3/4, c to be 1/4, and q to be 4. So based on those from the, also from 2 slides ago, we could then get alpha to be negative 1/2, beta to be 2, k to be 1/4, and p to be 1/2. So based upon that, plugging the different parts into where they belong from theorem one. We are going to obtain the general solution. Y of x would be equal to x to the negative 1/2 power times c sub 1 times j sub 1/2 of 1/4 times x squared plus c sub 2 times j sub negative 1/2 of 1/4 times x squared. So now from section 3.5, we have two approximations here that we have. So j sub 1/2 of z is equal to the square root of 2 divided by pi times z. The whole thing times the sine of z. And j sub negative 1/2 of z is the square root of 2 divided by pi times z. The whole thing times the cosine of z. So what does that mean? That means we could get our elementary form. By just plugging those in to our general solution and replacing those different parts. We're going to get y of x is equal to x to the negative 3/2 times a times the cosine of x squared over 4 plus b times the sine of x squared over 4. So for this next example, we want to solve the area equation. Y double prime plus 9xy is equal to 0. So we can multiply everything by x squared. So that is going to give us x squared times y double prime plus 9 times x cubed times y is equal to 0. Now here, a and b are both 0. C is 9, and q is 3, which means alpha is 1/2, beta is 3/2, k is 2, and finally, p is 1/3. So because of this, our general solution will take the form of y of x is equal to x to the 1/2 times c sub 1 times j sub 1/3 of 2x to the 3/2 plus c sub 2 times j sub negative 1/3 of 2 times x to the 3/2. So now an application of this is going to be the buckling of a vertical column. So if we take x is equal to 0, at the free top end of the column, and x is equal to L, which is greater than zero at the bottom. We want to denote the angular deflection of the column at the point x by theta of x, which is what it shows here in this picture at this particular point here. From the theory of elasticity, E times I times the second derivative of theta with respect to x plus G times rho of x, rho times x times theta is equal to zero. E is Young's modulus of the material of the column. I is the cross-sectional moment of inertia. Rho is the linear density of the column. G is the gravitational acceleration. And for physical reasons, the boundary conditions are going to be theta prime of zero to be the same thing as theta of L, and that to be zero. So we could form the eigenvalue problem, lambda being equal to gamma squared, which would be equal to G times rho divided by E times I, to make theta, the second derivative of theta plus gamma squared times x times theta is equal to zero. Theta prime of zero is zero. Theta of L is zero. And the column can buckle only if there is a non-trivial solution. Otherwise, the column will remain in its undeflected vertical position. And based upon this, the differential equation would be one of these area equations, just like an example two, where A and B are both zero, C is gamma squared, Q is 3, alpha is 1/2, beta is 3/2, K is 2/3, times gamma, and P is 1/3. So the general solution would be theta of x is equal to x to the 1/2 times C sub 1 times J sub 1/3 of 2/3 times gamma times x to the 3/2 plus C sub 2 times J sub negative 1/3 of 2/3 times gamma times x to the 3/2. We could substitute P to be positive and negative 1/3 in J sub P of x is equal to the sum from m is 0 to infinity of negative 1 to the mth power divided by m factorial times gamma of p plus m times 1 plus 1. So m factorial times gamma of p plus m times plus 1. All that times x over 2 to the 2m plus p power. So that simplifies just to make theta of x is equal to c sub 1 times gamma to the 1/3 power, divided by 3 to the 1/3, times gamma of 4/3. The whole thing times x minus gamma squared times x to the 4th over 12, plus gamma to the 4th times x to the 7th, divided by 504, and continuing alternating those signs, plus c sub 2 times 3 to the 1/3, divided by gamma to the 1/3, times gamma of 2/3, times 1 plus gamma squared times x cubed over 6, plus gamma to the 4th times x to the 6th, all divided by 180, and so on, again, alternating between those signs. Let me know if you have any questions or concerns. Thank you.